Mr. Carl Greaves for BritishBoxers.co.uk. Sir, an ex-fighter, trainer, manager, promoter, matchmaker, which one do you feel is your natural role? When you think of yourself, do you think of yourself as more as a manager, a trainer?
More of a trainer, I would say. That's when I feel most at home, most comfortable, working with the fighters, very active person myself. So I like being in the gym training the fighters, but I like the promoting. The promoting is a different side of it. I mean, obviously when I'm not in the gym, I'm in the office working on my show. So it's a little bit different, but I do feel like training is what I'm meant to do.
Talking about which, in a few weeks you have the rematch with Lezaraga, no?
Yeah,
in Spain.
That's right, yeah.
Now, after he beat Skeet and Frankie Gavin, there was a moment there where it seemed he casted a very fearsome shadow, Lezaraga. Going into the fight in his backyard, did you feel confident? Did you know? Did you spot in advance something you knew you could exploit? Were you confident going into Spain?
Yeah, I thought. I think Kermit's very one-dimensional. He's very, very powerful. Got good power, as his record speaks. But David's a very clever fighter. Thinks a lot, and we got the tactics spot on for that fight. And yeah, we was confident. Listen, I mean, we was in the own backyard. The thing I was most worried about was going to Bilbao, because we was told it was very hostile, obviously off Bradley and Frankie, that it's very hostile. But they are good people. They appreciated what David did in the ring, and they respected what we did. But leading up to the fight, I was probably more concerned about what was going to happen in Bilbao than obviously the opponent.
Hey, how do you see that rematch going?
I think it'll be sort of like a similar fight myself. I mean, Kermit's going to have to change his game a lot more than what David has. But we're very confident. I mean, we can't overlook Kermit because, like you say, he's got terrific power, heavy-handed both power in both hands. But I think we're going to get this right again and hopefully get Kermit out of the way and move on and try and get a world title fight.
Any news about Sam Bowen, sir?
Yeah, Sam, we're just waiting on a date now. We should be getting a date any time now, obviously from Frank Warren. We was told November. We haven't got the date and venue yet. So Sam's back now. He's ready to go. So we're just waiting on a date, and hopefully it won't be too long before that gets
announced. But are you out to clean the division domestically, or are you already moving up to
We would like to. I mean, Kikachi is the mandatory, so we'd like to win this mandatory. And then obviously getting the voluntary out of the way, win the belt outright, and then concentrate on moving into the WBO. I mean, he's WBO Intercontinental Champion, he's number 8 in the world, so there's no reason we can't push on and get a couple of defences of that and try and get a world title fight for the WBO.
Thank you. And about your activity, you know, all credit goes to you from many experts for the good job you're doing matchmaking for Ultimate Boxer.
Yeah.
So can I ask you, what criteria do you use in putting together a roster of 8 fighters? And do these criteria change according to the weight?
Yeah, I like the format I like to have is all hungry, up-and-coming fighters. I feel like they're going to give it all on the night. You have ex-fighters, ex-champions, who's coming back down to fight in the Ultimate Boxer. And I feel that because they've been used to the 10 and 12 round distance, they don't adapt to the 3 rounds as good as the up-and-coming prospects that's been boxing at 4 round level. So I feel if you get like an undefeated fighter who's had 6, 7, 8 fights coming in the competition and put them all in that, all 8 fighters in a hat together, I think you're just going to get an explosive night of action, which obviously the 4 I've put together so far has proved that. So I'm hoping we can stick to that format, and that's the way forward for me.
But are you able to tell the winner ahead? When you put together the roster, do you already have a feeling of who's going to come on top?
You know what? I've been asked this question before, and I just feel that anybody could win it on the night. I mean, listen, Michael Lawal on the last one, the Cruiserweight, was a big favourite, but he had hard fights in the quarters and the semi-finals, and it was harder than he expected. Everybody would think he'd walk through them, but they proved hard fights, and obviously he won the final in devastating fashion. But I mean, we've also had like a 22-1 win it before, a big outsider. So anybody could win it. It's on the night, and it's 3 rounds. It's a completely different style, completely different format. You give it everything you've got, and like you say, I think it suits fighters better than who's been fighting at championship level.
According to your own logic, Ben, was it a bit of a risk to put Dax Spellman into that format?
everything's a risk in boxing, but I feel that because Deck's explosive and got a good power, I just felt that it would suit him. I mean, Deck is a patient fighter, and he can adapt to the 10-round, 12-round level, but also he's explosive as well. He's got good power, so I felt very confident putting him in that tournament.
Why picking Peters for your first defense of the English title? Is it a personal thing?
Deck's really confident. We didn't have to pick this. I mean, obviously, it's a voluntary defense, so we didn't have to pick it. I mean,
exactly.
People's asked me why you picked it. The reason why I picked it, it's a big platform. It's BT Sport. It's a Frank Warren show. And Deck's very confident. He just feels like over 10 rounds, he feels like he's got Shakhan's number. He went into that Ultimate Boxer final with a broken nose. He was suffering. He had an hard lead up to the final. So we're just confident. I mean, it's good money, more money than we'd get anywhere else. It's a big platform, and it's a big prize if we win this. So let's hopefully we can put this to bed.
Thank you very much. All the best.
Thank you.